We are in Outside the Spacecraft, 50 Years of Extra-vehicular Activity. This is an exhibition being staged here at the museum in celebration of the 50th anniversary of the first spacewalks. We're in the middle of installing objects in preparation for our opening.
It's very inspiring to work on a project like this, to come down here and to see someone looking at something that interests them and excites them is very rewarding.
Space is a very dangerous place, and so to leave the spacecraft, to live and to work outside of it, we need what we call a personal spacecraft. That's the spacesuit.
This is the spacesuit display, first Gene Cernan spacesuit from his EVA activity in Gemini 9. And it's really, really fragile, so we really didn't think we could actually display this spacesuit at any point in its lifetime here at the museum until we came up with this system to support the suit at the top, which relieves pressure from the heavy section of the suit, and then supports the suit across the entire body. And what we're looking at is the interior suit of Gemini 9, Cernan's space EVA flight, with his cover layer next to it, it's kind of like an exploded view of the two suits together. We couldn't marry them back together. They had to be displayed separately. The object behind me is the umbilical cord that attached Ed White to a spacecraft during his Gemini 4 flight and kept him from floating away in space. It has a gold coating on the outside, which is really, really fragile. And over time, it's been left coiled, so we've displayed it that way to preserve the object so our visitors can see it on display. This object is being displayed by our museum for the very first time. It is the cover to the backpack that Gene Cernan wore on the moon, which had his life support system in it. And it was returned from the lunar surface with him during his mission in 1972. And NASA looked at the cover, examined it. We found out that they documented it and packaged it, where it remained sealed since 1973, 20 days after his mission. It was given to our museum and was kept in storage, preserved, and we opened it to display it for the very first time during this show. These boots before us were the last boots to walk on the moon. They were Gene Cernan's Apollo 17 EVA boots, which would go over the boot of a spacesuit and left footprints on the lunar surface. These have been displayed in our museum several times in other galleries, but we haven't shown them in this orientation. We thought it was important to show the actual boot that made the footprints on the moon.
The last section of the exhibit is on tools, and tools can range anything from very basic tools that you might use here on Earth to things that are highly specialized for the space environment. So we have cameras, timekeeping devices, checklists, special cameras, and foot restraints. One of our most spectacular objects in the exhibit is what's called Manipulator foot restraint from the last of the Hubble servicing missions, STS-125. As I was doing my work as a curator and visually confirming that the object had indeed flown on STS-125, our curator worked with NASA and found through their paperwork that not only had it flown on STS-125, it had also flown previous missions as well. The glove exhibit we're installing is really a centerpiece, quite literally, of the entire gallery. It sits in the center of the gallery and is a pretty extraordinary looking feature. We do have some historic gloves in the display itself. One of the most important is Kathy Sullivan's glove from her EVA as the first U.S. woman to do an EVA during the shuttle program. There's another thread in the exhibit, and that's about art and photography. And so I wanted to select artwork from our collection that really demonstrates how artists have interpreted the experience of astronauts on EVA. And the photographs, including the one here at the entrance to the gallery, are really evocative of that experience.
I really wanted to inspire the next generation. So there's a lot of big scenes in the gallery.
We can't go there ourselves, but the visuals are really what bring that home for all of us.